Both ShopSite Manager and ShopSite Pro have a product search feature which you can enable in your store. To turn on a product search feature, you're going to log into your ShopSite back office and click on Pages. Here you can highlight all of your pages and then do Power Edit. There's two fields you'll want to select, the search products and the index products. Once you select those, click on Proceed. This product search field checkbox is to display the search field on your page. Most merchants are going to display the search field on all of their store pages. However, there are some cases where merchants don't want a search field on a particular page. For the index checkbox, that's saying you want the products listed on that page to be indexed in your search. There are cases where merchants don't want this. For example, if you're using both ShopSite for wholesale and retail, you may not want to have your wholesale products indexed because when a customer in the retail side does a search, you don't want those products to be displayed. However, again, most merchants are going to want all their pages to be indexed. So once you have the settings the way you want, where the product search field is going to show up and what page you're indexed, save changes at the bottom. Now you can publish your store, and during the publish, ShopSite will index your products, and you can view your website. So refresh your page, and you should have a search field on your page, either in the header or left navigation. So let's place a test search. Let's search for toy. Here's my search results page. The page name, search results, the search results and the keyword I used, and then you'll see that my results are in three different columns. I'm going to change my layout, one, so that I have this search box at the top and bottom of my pages, two, that my product search results are at 4 per row instead of 3 per row, and three, I'm going to remove the page name because the search results that I search for with the keyword is right below it. So to modify your search settings, log into your ShopSite back office, go to Preferences, and then click on Search Settings. The first option, Search Indexing, controls how the indexing is going to work in your store. You can choose keywords that you don't want indexed, and you can select the fields you do want indexed, as well as the relevance of those fields. Since most customers aren't going to be searching by the SKU in my store, that relevance is pretty low. But the product description is really high. You can choose to index numbers, and if your SKUs have numbers in them, you'll want to index numbers. And you can choose whether or not you're going to include the subproducts in your indexing or display your keywords. Save changes once you have the settings the way you'd like. Under search content, it's going to be the same as page content. So it has the page name, the banner graphic, and text fields on the page for you to change what's displayed. Save changes when you're done. On search layout, this is going to control a lot of the same things that edit page layout does. So you can choose whether to display the name and the graphic or not, and I don't want to display the name, so I'm unchecking that checkbox. You can select the templates you'd like to use, the size of the product images, the number of columns that are used, so I'm going to change it from 3 columns to 4 columns. The page width, header and footer, and colors on the page. In this next section, under Search Page Configuration, you can choose how the product description is displayed. So I'm going to have up to 300 characters displayed of my product description in the search results. And these next areas are if your products have quantity pricing or variable pricing. In the search results header and footer, this is where that search bar that you saw, so on our search results page, that's where this bar is configured, how it looks, how wide this field is, and what sort by options are available. So you'll see we have it just at the bottom right now, but you can check the checkbox so it appears at the top as well. You can change the layout so it's horizontal or vertical. You can say how wide you want the search field, whether you want the result count, and the pagination, and the maximum number of results to show. I have it set to 0, so it's going to show all of the results. If you have thousands of products, you may want to limit the number of results so that there aren't too many paginated pages. And I want to allow sorting by all options, so by relevance, by price, and alphabetically. In the advanced search, You can choose if you want to allow customers the advanced search option and configure how that's going to be set up. If you do allow the advanced search, I typically say to have whole words and do an auto new search with stems if nothing's found, and have the stem come after the word. However, in my store, I don't think I need the advanced search because it's just toys, so I'm just going to say never. Save changes when you're done, and then publish your new changes. So let's refresh my page, and you'll see now the advanced search is gone. My products are in 4 columns. The search is at the top of the page as well, and I got rid of the page name, so now it just has my search results 4 and it has the keyword that I set. The last section in your back office under Preferences, Search Settings, and is Search Logging. And this allows you to get your summary of what customers are searching for in your store. You'll want to configure this the first time, enable it, and if you want to make it so that your IP or your domain isn't indexed in the search, so if you search in your own store, they won't be counted, enter your IP in here. Save changes when you're done, and next time when you go into search logging, it'll give you the number of searches that are placed, the top term with results, and the top term without results. That way you can see if customers are searching for specific things in your store that you do have, but maybe no results are coming up. You can modify the keywords or the product descriptions so that that doesn't happen. And this completes the video tutorial for the search settings in your ShopSite store.